Thank you once again, my viewers, children of God everywhere, brothers and sisters. The topic for today is why God is unable to have total rule over the earth. Why God is unable to have total rule over the earth. Father, once again, we want to ask that you do a new thing at this moment, and so that you will bless both the speaker and the hearers, so that at the end of everything, only your name shall be glorified. In Jesus' name, amen. Why God is unable to have total rule over the earth? Well, at first, some people may begin to think, I think God is God, so he should be able to have total rule over the earth. Well, it doesn't always work that way. However, it is generally acknowledged, known, accepted that God created all things, including the earth, for his glory. God created everything for his glory. Actually, Psalm 24, verse 1 says, the earth is the Lord's, and the fullness thereof. Can you imagine that? The earth is the Lord's, and the fullness thereof. Okay? So, now, God is God over all things, including the earth. Yes, there is no doubt about that, because God is still God. God is God. And there is nothing anyone can do about that. However, this may surprise you that God is not the one ruling the earth at the moment. God is not the one ruling the earth at the moment. The scripture tells us in 1 John chapter 5, verse 19, that the whole world lies in the power of the evil one, that is the devil. Then number two, the Bible also says in Luke chapter 4, verses 5 and 6, the devil here was claiming that he owns this earth, and that it was given to him, and that he could give it to anyone he wanted. So, I want you to take note of all these things. So, again, the Bible says in 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 4, that Satan is the god of this world. That may shock you. That's what the Bible says. Satan is the god of this world. So, I suspect you are now thinking that why should God have allowed Satan to become the God of this world? Why? You know, well, you will have to understand that God actually wants to rule on earth. He wants his will to be done perfectly on earth. That was why in the Lord's Prayer, our Lord Jesus Christ taught his disciples. That's Matthew 6, verse 10. He said, "Thy will be done on earth." So, it is the will of God that his will, his perfect will be done on earth. But practically, this is not what has been happening. And we will see in a while. We have to realize that even though God created and owned the earth, He gave rulership of the earth to man, Adam. So He gave rulership of the earth to Adam. So we can see this in Genesis 1. 26, you know, so God conferred dominion on Adam. He conferred rulership upon Adam. Adam was to rule the earth according to the will of God. It was to represent God. So, as a representative of God, he actually had a responsibility to report to God concerning his rulership, his dominion. So, when he was given the dominion over the earth, Adam had his headquarters in the Garden of Eden. So he had his headquarters there. But he was declared ruler over the whole earth. However, unfortunately, Adam lost it. He lost it totally. And God's enemy came on to exercise control over the earth, to exercise dominion over the earth, to exercise rulership over the earth. You know, so because of this, man became a plaything in the hands of the enemy, the devil. So instead of man ruling, the devil was now ruling with all that accompanied that. So, let's continue. What I'm saying is that according to scriptures, Satan became the ruler over the earth, even though he's not the owner. I want you to take note of that carefully. Satan became ruler over the earth, even though he's not the owner of the earth. We should never forget that when God gave the dominion over the earth to Adam, it has a leasehold. You know, so that leasehold was to be enjoyed by Adam. You know? So, but cleverly, the enemy of God and man played a quick one and appropriated the dominion over the earth to himself. So we must follow the sequence and what really happened in the process. So it is important for us to know and understand the nature of the earth in which we live. Many times people ask questions. Some of these questions should not have arisen if people knew what really happened, how God gave man dominion over the earth, how man lost dominion over the earth, how Satan seized control of the earth, how he became the God of this world. So, if people, especially children of God, understand these things, some of the questions they ask at times will not be asked. They will begin to concentrate on more important things and how to make progress spiritually. So, it was this leasehold, Adam's leasehold, that the devil is now enjoying. He was bold enough to tell our Lord Jesus Christ in Luke 4, verses 5 to 6. He said, "The whole earth belongs to me. It was given to me." Yeah, and he wasn't lying when he said that. You know, it was handed over to him by man. So instead of man ruling over him, he's the one ruling over humans. You can see the whole world today, everywhere, in Africa, in Asia, in Australia, Europe, South America, North America, all sorts of things, to tell us that the devil is a bad devil. He rules the earth. He rules human lives. He rules their destinies, especially those of them who have not repented of their sins and come to Jesus Christ. He does. So, it is that leasehold that the devil is now enjoying. Adam's leasehold. He's enjoying Adam's leasehold to not be forever a time will come when the leasehold will expire. And he knows it. The devil knows it. You know? So, God, in his wisdom, plotted a way to take the dominion away from Satan legally. This was why our Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God, came as a man. Because it was man that lost dominion. It must be man who must win dominion over the earth. And this was exactly what Jesus Christ did. So, our Lord Jesus Christ has won dominion over the devil. And the devil knows, because the Lord Jesus Christ defeated the devil in every way. Defeated sin. Defeated the flesh. Defeated evil spirits. Defeated the world. He defeated Satan and all the powers of darkness, making an open show of them. So the dominion now resides in our Lord Jesus Christ. We must take note of this. We must understand this. We must know this. Because one of the most dangerous things is to walk about in ignorance. Because if you are ignorant, the devil will be quick to manipulate you. But if you have the understanding of the word of God, if you have the understanding of the will of God, if you have the understanding of the purposes and the plans of God, you will not be moved. My friends, so Jesus took over. He took back the dominion over the earth by doing and finishing the work of redemption on the cross of Calvary. You know, even though the Bible still says that Satan is the God of this world, that is, his God over fallen humanity. God over fallen humanity. But if anyone will come to Jesus, if anyone will key into Jesus, he or she will also exercise that dominion over the earth through Christ. That is it. It is our responsibility as children of God. It is our responsibility as sons and daughters of God. It is our responsibility as men, women of God, to understand that dominion over the earth can only be exercised through Christ. When we talk about dominion, some people think dominion is merely having control over all sorts of material riches. If you do not know the Lord, if you are not saved, whatever you have, Satan can lay claim on them. That is why you must be rooted in the Son of the Living God. That is why you must know that it is your responsibility to rule over the earth. In fact, That was God's plan originally. You know? So, if this is to happen, if man is to exercise real dominion over the earth, he must do so only through our Lord Jesus Christ. Otherwise, Satan can claim, can put forward a counterclaim. That is why it is important for children of God, Christians, to do everything in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, the one who has won dominion over the earth, the one who has defeated the enemy, the one who has exercised power over every aspect of life. My friends, my brothers and sisters. So, I want you to know this so that you can order your life, your steps accordingly, so that you'll be able to live a life of victory. There's no other victory, any other place or anywhere else without the victory accomplished on the cross through our Lord Jesus Christ. Do not be deceived. Do not be deceived. Only Christ's victory can ensure our victory. And he was victorious. He remains victorious. Our Lord Jesus Christ. So, my brothers and sisters, you have to know this. You have to always abide in him. Our Lord Jesus Christ actually said it. He said, abide in me. Look at that. Because he knows if we don't, we have no chance. No chance. So, it is only in our own interest that we abide in him. He said, if you abide in me and I abide in you, you ask anything and it shall be done. Look at that. So, my friends, my brothers and sisters, you know, some people may tell you that they can exercise control or authority or dominion wherever they go on some aspects of life without Christ. Well, I will have to tell you that that's part of the deception. The devil does give what we may call a semblance of dominion to those whom he will eventually destroy. Real dominion resides in Christ, who won the victory, who fulfilled the will, the perfect will of the Father. You know, this is important. My friends, my brothers and sisters, so it's important for us to understand this. It's important for us to know this. It is important for us to internalize this, because it will go a long way to smoothing our path on our spiritual journey. So when I say the leasehold which Satan is enjoying now, it at a point it will run out. That is why you've heard several times in the word of God, our Lord Jesus Christ said it himself. He said, I'm coming back to take over. So that means this will be when the leasehold of Adam, which Satan is exercising now, will expire. And the devil knows this. And all his satanic forces, they know. They know their time is short. We children of God should know this as well and make use of the knowledge for the glory of God and to the glory of God. So the king is coming, and the devil knows, and his satanic forces. So both heaven and earth are preparing. Everyone is preparing for the coming of the Lord. Is the one. That's why our Lord Jesus Christ always called himself the Son of Man. You see? So, he took back the dominion which Adam lost. And that's why the Bible refers to him as the last Adam. In 1 Corinthians chapter 15, is the last Adam. He succeeded where Adam failed. He won the victory. And the devil knows. The devil knows that Jesus is Lord. The devil knows that Jesus has won the victory. The devil knows that Jesus is coming soon. The devil knows that his dominion over the earth will soon end. The devil knows that his rulership over the earth is for some time, and it will soon expire, my friends. So you need to know this. You need to do what is right with the knowledge. You need to exercise dominion through Christ. Because you have been given that dominion through Christ. Is there any area of your life where the devil is harassing you? You just need to key into Christ, through whom you are able to exercise dominion over every aspect of life. Is it over your health? Is it over your finances? Is it over your work? Is it over your family life? It's important. It is very, very important. Do not look for victory somewhere else. There are people in the world today, they are looking for dominion, for rulership, for power. And they believe the only way, the only place they can go is to the enemy of God and the enemy of their souls. How can that make sense? When we have the Lord Jesus Christ, who legally won the victory back from the devil, is the one who is able to give victory, dominion, rulership back to man. No wonder he said, "Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest." Can you imagine that? You can find no rest anywhere else. You can find no rest in magic. You can find no rest in the occult. You can find no rest in necromancy. You can find no rest in witchcraft. You can find no rest in no other place. Only Jesus can give you rest, because it's the real deal. He's the one who won the victory. He won the victory. You know, he destroyed the powers of darkness. That's why at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow and every tongue must confess that Jesus is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. My friends, what are you going to do? Do not be deceived. Dominion only lies in Christ Jesus Christ. Victory only lies in the Lord Jesus Christ. Are you not going to come to him? Or if you know him already, are you not going to continue to dig deep and continue to key into him for grace, for power? Because he's there. He is our Lord. He's done it. He's done it. So we have no excuse. No one has any excuse. Our Lord Jesus Christ won the victory over 2,000 years ago. I'm surprised. There are still millions of people who still run to the devil, the enemy of man, for dominion, for riches. Whereas, whatever he gives you was stolen from you. From what God gave to mankind. And you allow yourself to be deceived. He gives one or two things to you. And he gives you some silly conditions. Some were told they would have to pay with their lives. Or the lives of people close to them. This happens all the time around the world. Because people don't know. Or even if they have a glimpse of the real thing or the truth, they can't be bothered. Let me tell you this. If you allow the devil to own you, to make friends with you, to deceive you into thinking that he can give you freedom and dominion, then you are deceived. And you may spend your eternity regretting it. What am I saying? My brothers and friends, my sisters, let us key into the Lord Jesus Christ who won the victory. And it will be well with us in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.